Welcome back to Higurashi. No nakokoro ni Watanagashi. No, I'm just gonna get rid of all that. Just start here.
Lower our volume.
It's too loud.
You're too loud.
Too loud.
Which is funny because you're never loud. Hey. You're either quiet as a mouse or you're screaming your head off. There's nothing in between with you. I knew we wouldn't be doing any club activities after school today before Mion even said anything. I've been invited over by Shion for an all-you-can-eat dessert. I made a point of leaving half my lunch uneaten. My expectations would only be rivaled by my hunger.
Keichi-kun, you seem kind of happy today. Did something good happen? Did it?
Oh, that's right. We got that call from Shion last time.
Gotta be a taste tester for the dessert.
Ooh, this is
gonna all be dessert. I guess it was obvious. Reina had questioned me with a happy look. That's right, why don't I invite Reina for dessert as well? Now, if I recall correctly, Shion said something about having a ticket. At worst, the restaurant might be admission by ticket only today. If that was the case, then having Reina be turned away at the door would result in the worst feeling ever. Yeah, I got a little lucky. I'll tell you about it tomorrow. Reina, you'll definitely be jealous.
Whoa, whoa, whoa! What is it? What is it? I'm jealous! I'm jealous! This lucky thing! Is it cute? Is it...
cute? Huh. I wonder what Reina would think of uniforms that Angel wore. They'd definitely be a critical hit. Probably. It's probably pretty cute.
What? I'm jelly jelly! What is it? What is it?
Huh? What kind of fortune were you blessed with? Huh? Could it be you participated in the draw Angel Mort about 2 months ago? And won?
Hey, no, I didn't even transfer here 2 months ago.
Oh, that's right. Then it's not Angel's Dessert Festa then.
Mi-chan, what's Angel's Dessert Festa exactly?
You know, there's that family restaurant called Angel Mort right by Okinomiya Station? Every season they hold events to promote their new dessert menu. That's today. Oh, it's no use going. The restaurant is reserved for people who won the draw. Mion explained once again what Shio had explained to me last night.
Reina will have to stop by the restaurant sometime. I'll do my best to draw a winning ticket and aim to enter the next all-you-can-eat event.
Knock yourself out. By the way, this is just something I heard, but there's a rumor that the tickets are being sold in the black market for a pretty penny. Hearing that story, I felt even more appreciative of the ticket that Shion had procured for me. I just thought I was lucky to be able to eat dessert for free, but it turned out that the ticket was much more valuable. The number of things I had to thank Shion for had increased again. Thanks. I didn't know it was worth so much. I whispered in a voice only Mio could hear. That was how I conveyed my feelings. Mion looked at me for a moment before she tilted her head to the side and smiled confusedly.
Huh? What? Did you say something?
It would be a problem if you said something to me right now. That smile seemed to be telling me as much. I guess Mion wouldn't be accepting any gratitude while she was Mion. I'll go to the restaurant. Today I'll thank Mion while she's Shion.
Well, then this old man will take his leave here. The work today is going to be a little rough. Later!
Mion waved her hand energetically as she left.
Is it just me or are they having a lot less club activities because people are like doing their own thing?
Yeah, it definitely seems like that way. I think this is because if it was just club activity after club activity by episode 2, it got a little repetitive.
Yeah.
Hey, Keichi-kun! Mion-chan has been kind of weird lately. Like she's elated or something.
Huh? What? You think so? Reina was pretty sharp when it came to these types of things. To me, Mion seemed the same as always, but Reina apparently felt something different.
You don't know, Keichi-kun? I totally thought you knew!
Reina's skirt fluttered as she spun around with a coy smile. Oh, what exactly? I was obviously weaseling my way out of the question, but I wasn't lying. Honestly, I didn't really know what was going on. Why did Shion, a persona of Mion that she created, appear before me? Something was blatantly up, but Reina paid it no heed.
Oh, really? I wonder what it is then. Okay.
Oh, really? I wonder what it is then. When Mii-chan is in a good mood, so is Reina.
Oh. Saying that, she spread her arms wide and spun around happily.
Oh.
I didn't know why, but Reina was in a really good mood. It was so infectious that I had a smile too. Even the chirping of the cicadas seemed joyful. But you see, Reina abruptly stopped spinning. Her expression returned to a more somber one.
You see, Mii-chan, lately, she's been in a lot of pain.
What do you mean? Pain? The pain that Reina was talking about was probably wasn't physical.
At first she tried to pretend it wasn't a big deal, but like a wound, it began to fester and grow. Eventually she was no longer able to bear the pain and woke up in the middle of the night. And then she phoned Reina. Mii-chan was crying.
I'm sorry. What are you talking about?
What am I talking about? Huh? What is Reina talking about? What?
Hey, don't play dumb like that. Just now, you said.
I don't know. Reina doesn't know anything. Ow.
Reina spun as she laughed innocently. Eventually, she appeared to get sick, stumbling as she steadied herself with her hand against the wall.
Oh, room is bitten.
That was dumb. That's what you get for getting carried away and spinning like that.
I'm sorry. Oh, I think I feel sick.
I'll lend the ditz a shoulder to lean on. To be stumbling around like a newborn foal at this age is actually quite a feat. Reina, in a good mood, only babbled incoherently after that. I laughed as I responded to and chided her. However, the chance to revisit that heavy topic Reina had brought up never arrived.
Ugh!
Sorry, I had to clear my throat.
Blah!
Airbow. As soon as I got home, I tossed aside my school bag and chains in a hurry. The effects of only having a light lunch were starting to show, as my stomach began to let out fickle growls. Alright, let's go to Angel Mart! It's time to face the land of endless desserts! Preparations for battle are complete! Tally-ho!
Tally-ho?
Tally-ho! Angel Mart had a decidedly different feel to it compared to yesterday. Dessert Festa today, admittance by reservation only. Nonetheless, the front of the store was being swarmed by over a dozen young men. Judging by how they were looking upwards in jealousy instead of entering the store, they weren't invitees. Why would they gather here if they knew they couldn't get in? I found out the answer when I passed through the crowd and began to climb the steps to the restaurant.
Are you a participant? Do you have a ticket?
Yeah. Well, I was lucky. As soon as I said that, I was immediately mobbed. It was like being in the middle of a football scrum on a crowded train.
What is going on?
The reason was this. It wasn't just one ticket per person. One ticket could let up to 4 people inside. So it's like that, huh? Seems like I should have invited Reina and the others. Thanks for the tip. But I'll pretend I didn't hear that. With an uplifting smile, I turned and ignored them. When I did, their arms all reached out at once like the souls of the damned seeking succor.
That ticket can admit up to 4 people! Please bring us with you!
What selfish people? This was the only reason they were crowded in front of the restaurant? Dozens of wretched arms reached out for me like the teeth on a giant rake and grasped at the air. I was already climbing the stairs to the entrance.
What a heartless dick! Grab him!
This isn't something to joke about! I flew up the rest of the stairs and threw myself inside the restaurant. It's like I'd entered a different world.
What a dick!
Heartless dick! Quack!
Was the dick in your mouth? The miserable throng of the damned hurled curses at me from the other side of the glass door. But inside of this completely soundproofed and air-conditioned restaurant, the angelic smile of a waitress to welcome me, there were nothing more than a refreshing piece of scenery. I knew that I shouldn't laugh, but I began to let out a sinister cackle. Good afternoon. Welcome to Angel Mort. Due to today's dessert fest, the restaurant is reserved for customers who want the draw. Can I ask for your name and ticket?
I don't have a ticket, but I should be on the guest list. Mayabara? Mayabara.
There it is.
I'm sorry, but may I please have your full name?
Keichi. Keichi Mayabara. My apologies for the inconvenience. You're here by special invitation, right? I'll show you to your seat. Please, this way.
The mood inside the room was incredibly heated. The booths were packed to the brim. Men in their prime were stuffing their faces with dainty desserts that didn't suit them at all. It was a rather unnerving spectacle. Soon after, I was shown to my seat. Shion arrived.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Angel Mort.
Hey Shion, thanks so much for today. I really appreciate it.
You were a bit late, so I was getting worried. I'm really happy you came though.
It may have been because the other customers were around that her tone was less casual, but she still kept off that welcome with her usual brilliant smile.
As you can see, there's a lot of customers here today. I'm not sure I'll be able to take a break. Please take your time and relax until I'm finished. When I'm done, let's go play somewhere, okay?
Whispering just that last part into my ear, Shion winked and returned to the kitchen. Maybe it was because the mood in the restaurant was so heated, but Shion seemed a bit bolder. Even a small change in her mannerisms was enough to set my heart aflutter.
So good.
They look delish.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
While I was overwhelmed by the atmosphere inside the restaurant, orders from the new summer menu were carried out one after another. Every single one was extravagantly huge.
I get it, you can eat all of these amazing things for free! No wonder a ticket was worth its weight in gold.
On top of that, all of it was plenty delicious. From dishes with a general appeal to insane ones aimed at a specific audience, there were absolutely no gaps in their repertoire.
No matter how you look at it, I don't think one person can eat this much.
Well, let's just leave it at that for now. I didn't feel relaxing in here at all. Probably because the fervor inside the restaurant was clearly abnormal. All the other booth seats were crammed with groups of four. Sleazy men were gorging like pigs on cutely decorated desserts, and it wouldn't have been a surprise if they started licking the place. It was more than a little unsettling. It piqued my interest, so I started listening in on their conversations. What things I heard.
Oh no.
Angel Mort, somewhere!
Me? I bought my ticket for 70,000 on Dacted Auctions.
I told work that I was attending a relative's funeral. The uniforms here are the greatest!
I wonder if the wages would wipe it for me if I spilled some water on my pants right now.
So, meow.
I heard they're planning on selling Angel Mort figures. We'll have to pay heed at the next Wonder Festival.
They sell used Angel Mort uniforms on the fourth floor of Redacted in Occupa. But they cost $280,000.
Tis an absurd price. Anmo cost $80,000 when Probar closed down the gate for going when the going rate for theirs was $12,000. That's the price for used ones. Knock off at least half that.
Knockoff for Jack is fine with me. I wonder if they'll start selling them. Then I'll put it on my life-size figure I did buy off of Redacted for several hundred thousand. If I can wake up every day to an angel from Angel, that'll really get my gears going.
Words spilling out of their mouths are pretty much all I don't know why I couldn't say that word today. But they still keenly conveyed that hidden behind them was an invisible aura of abnormality.
Sorry to keep you waiting. The next dessert is Tropical Cinnamon Love Affair. Something the matter?
No. It's kind of different inside the restaurant today. Our restaurant is pretty famous in the circles. Well, we were aiming for that, so it's all well and good. But during Festus, there's something of the more hardcore crowd, so it can be a handful. The waitress informed me quietly with a wry smile. Customers seem rather riled up, almost like a pack of hyenas.
seems a lot of the customers today came from reasonably far away. Those types of people are fairly prone to losing their self-control, so it's a little scary. If you don't keep your guard up, something bad can happen. What did she mean by keep your guard up? At that moment, a large crash resounded through the room. Well. Turned around, startled to see that a waitress had fallen down and spilled the order she was carrying right onto a customer. Wait, isn't that Shion?
I'm so sorry. Your food is,
Oh, what have you done? The jeans that I bought at a certain specialty shop for a whole 1,800 yen are all sticky with frosting.
What the hell is that? For somebody who just met with disaster, he seems awfully happy.
How tragic. It seems that...
How tragic! It seems that little Miss Waitress here will have to wipey-wipey it up from the bottom of her heart.
Conversation suddenly veered off in an odd direction. Hey, what did he say? Wipey-wipey? Did he want Shio to wipe him down? Right over that obviously aberrant tent he had pitched over his crotch.
But that is... I... Wipe...
Who's saying wipey-wipey?
Wipey-wipey! 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 Wipey-wipey!
Sounds like a baby.
The wipey-wipey chant quickly spread throughout the room.
Oh, that was a chant!
Yeah.
Wipey-wipey! 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 Wipey-wipey!
Totally cornered, Shion went pale. She looked over to a more experienced waitress for help, was only met with a head shaking out of pity. Poor Shion. Sonizaki-san was tripped. Customers who do that to purposely get their clothes dirty have been on the rise lately. Ah, so you're saying she was tripped? What happened just now wasn't an accident. It was on purpose? Regular girls are careful about it so they definitely won't end up like that, but Sonizaki-san is a seasonal hire, so she had her guard down. Customers today could easily pick up on that, so she'd been targeted since this morning. What's the manager doing? He should just kick those thugs out. We're in the service industry, so there's not much we can do about it. She laughed as she said that in a resigned tone. Shion trembled uncontrollably with a dishcloth in her hands as she turned bright red. The man who had been doused in frosting splayed out on the bench, putting the cream-covered tent over his crotch on full display. Still mentally unprepared, a trembling hand inched forward, goaded on by onlookers.
Come! It is the time for the wipey-wipey!
From my male point of view, it might have been a ridiculous spectacle I could just smile wryly at, but from a woman's point of view, this was obviously pure humiliation.
Oh no.
So is Keichi gonna step in this time? Oh, I think he's gonna step in for her this time. Mm-hmm. When I was trapped by those thugs and had been paralyzed with fear, Shion fearlessly stood up to them and saved me. Still, as humiliating as it was, Shion was also partly to blame for this, and it wasn't as though her life was at stake, right? Even these guys, they were just going to jeer at her in a bit of a lewd situation. It's not like they were going to eat Shion alive or anything. You know, if I just consoled her afterwards. Even I was scared, but Keichan was in trouble, so I had to be brave and do my best. When I, a man, was being assailed by three thugs while paralyzed with fear, she didn't save me without a second thought. What about now? These sleazy, filthy degenerates were trying to pin the blame on Shion. This time our roles were reversed. Hey, Keichi Marubara. If you don't save her now, when will you be able to repay that debt you owe her? You scared Keichi Marubara? At that time, Mion, didn't even show a hint of hesitation. And what about now? I'm not hesitating. Then what? If you're not hesitating, then why aren't you helping her? Now resign yourself to your fate! Shut up, you greasy fat ass. Get out of here before I get angry. I grasped Shion's shoulder firmly and pulled her behind me. Keichan! It seems you don't understand. Yonder waitress was the one who... Oh.
It seems you don't understand. Yonder waitress was the one who wet mine pants.
This is her punishment! The one who needs punishing is you. Enough with the empty words. If you're a man, talk with your fists.
Ooh, foot smash!
My body was lifted in the air like nothing. I was thrown right back into my own seat. This guy is strong? No matter how you look at it, athletic and this Lardo aren't even the same area code. Many otaku are unexpectedly well versed in some obscure martial art. Don't be underestimating us! Man smirked, showing off his gum line.
Keichi, are you okay?
Damn it. How lame must I look right now?
You were tripped, weren't you, Shion?
They're the ones in the wrong here, so don't let them take advantage of you.
That may be, but it was still my fault.
Whoa! One more time! Let's do it! Snap the cross!
Don't you go thinking that this is enough to make me give up?
One more time!
Honestly, I don't know.
Whack, snap, thunk!
You're all talk.
I'm not done. Yeet! Rise, my will to fight!
Not just running, I planted every one of my steps firmly as I chose the distance to the lard ball. Each time I ripped my foot off the floor, I could feel my burning spirit flare up from the point of impact.
Oh no.
Everything slowed down like I was walking underwater. As I stepped forward in that viscous flow of time, I calmly measured the gap between us. With our difference in height, reach was my ultimate advantage. There was an ever so tiny distance between us where only my punch would be able to reach. I unleashed my iron fist of righteous anger, but it flew towards his face slowly, like I was punching underwater. Reacting to that with a smirk on his face, the fatso easily slipped inside my punch. I hadn't realized it until now, but in this mired time, I was able to observe his baffling counterattack with almost painful clarity. His arm slowly swung around in a large windmill motion, wrapped around my whiff punch, and descended in an arc. That arm swung around like the arms of a clock. It came into contact with my head, twisting my upper body around. Dragging my head along, he followed through with another rotation. This time he rotated his entire body like a top, followed by another rotation. Combining defense and offense, it was a brilliant counter. That's right, three times. I was thrown after three rotations, I think. In this vicious rain of time, I was unable to struggle, and I could only wait dumbstruck until the moment I was thrown. The moment I was, that sluggish temporal anomaly abruptly ended.
Oof. Got the crap beaten out of him. Still shaking.
Not stirred.
Still shaking.
Crash! You lack training, young man.
I was loath to admit it, but against somebody trained in martial arts, I couldn't win through force of will alone. After my consciousness faded in a wave of dizziness, when I came to, I was lying down in my own seat. Thankfully, you weren't injured. More experienced waitress from before wiped the sweat from my brow with a towel. While she was doing that, a red-faced and teary-eyed Shion trudged over.
Are you okay? Doing that all for my sake, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry too, I wasn't much help. I've never won a fight before.
No, you just trying to help me made me happy.
I'm not joking.
It's just that when I was thinking that it was lucky Keichi came here today.
As she said that, she stuck her tongue out teasingly. She wiped off the whipped cream with the washcloth she was holding in her hands. Sonazaki-san, you can take your break now. You still have 1 or 2 hours left, don't you?
No, it's fine. Even though it's just part-time, it's still a paying job. I want it properly while I'm on the clock. So really, you don't have to worry about me. She couldn't even put up a brave front. I would never even think for a second that Mion could be that weak. This was Shion, and she had been harassed by someone in unreasonable riffraff. That was reality.
Kei-chan, don't mind me. Please eat as much dessert as you can. When you're done, we'll have you fill out a survey. Well then, I've got to get back to the floor.
After some consoling words and a sympathetic smile to Shion, the other waitresses started to head back to work. That's where I stopped her. Excuse me. Could I borrow your phone?
The phone?
It's by the register. I'll show you where. I pulled a 10 yen coin from my wallet. This wasn't about saving face. My being a worthless coward was an unchangeable fact, but I could just cry myself to sleep about that later tonight. Now was not the time for tears. I had to fight! If I recall, one ticket is good for up to 4 people, right? Is it alright if I call over 3 more people?
Yes, that's fine. For the time being, I'll write them down on the guest list. Could I have their names?
I turned around and glared at the greasy hooligan who subjected Shion to that thought popped in my head that he's gonna call Reyna and he's gonna say he was picking on Shion, and Reyna's gonna be like, "You monster!" and beat the crap out of him.
What if he invites Reyna?
What if he invites Mio? I doubt he will. It wouldn't make sense.
I think he's gonna invite Reyna, Satoko, and Riku.
Yeah. There are 3 things that aren't working in your favor today, punk. The first is that I owe Shion. The second is that I'm a man who's not afraid to throw away his pride to win. And the third is that we're the most powerful club members in history. Please add Reyna Ryugu, Satoko Hojo, and Rika Furude to the guest list.
Called it!
Understood. I'll do that. I'll have the best and most powerful club members join the fray. They can bring down 1,000 foes. You fat asses. Prepare to meet your maker!
This is getting interesting. I like this show.
Oh, this is a nice restaurant! Oh, the uniforms are cute! Reyna wants to wear them too!
Oh god.
Oh.
Could you imagine Reyna in the outfit?
On top of that, we're being treated dessert. I'm deeply moved.
Yeah, eat as much as you like. Don't worry about my share.
Keichi-san, enough of the charades. Let's get to the point.
Reyna and Rika-chan put down their forks when Satoko broached the subject. After looking at them for a few moments, I pressed my forehead firmly into the table. I beg of you! I don't care if you make fun of how pathetic I am. Please lend me your strength. The 3 of them seemed surprised by the sudden turn of events, but nevertheless listened to what I had to say without making fun of my unusual behavior.
Well, what's the matter? Something happened, didn't it?
Actually, Mion's younger sister Shion is working part-time at this restaurant.
Ah, my little sister you were talking about, right? Could it be her? Could it? She resembles her.
Resemble? That's just Mion with her hair down, isn't it? I didn't know what to say.
If Keichi says that's Shion, then that's Shion.
They might be twins, but can they really look that much alike?
Yep.
They're called monozygotic twins. They really can look identical.
Reyna gave the most plausible explanation so everybody else was convinced. Well then, do you believe me? I'll get to the point then.
Oh no.
I recounted everything that had just happened. How Shion was targeted, how she was antagonized by the customers and humiliation that was forced upon her. Also how incredibly pathetic I was. I included everything without trying to hide it.
But that's awful! Poor Shion! However, for you to be unable to help her, there should be a limit to how unsightly you can be.
There's nothing I can say to that.
Satoko-chan, to admit that you lost to seek help is a very difficult thing to do. Keichi-kun, just just to help Shichan rather than save his pride.
So pathetic.
Reina's follow-up stung a bit, but I could only be thankful that she understood. Sakuga was calling me all sorts of names, but there was no malign intentions behind her words.
Then what should we do?
Her voice was monotone, but there was a hint of resolve in her words. I replied to Rika-chan's suggestive silence in kind with my own quiet resolve.
Well, I thought it would be something like that. It is a bit much for Keiji-san to handle alone.
Huh? Then you'll help?
Of course, Keiji-kun! We'll help anybody who's being bullied!
I remember when I was cornered by those thugs, what Shion had said about the strong feelings of solidarity in Amizawa really began to hit home. However, Keiichi Marubara, now is not time to get choked up with tears of gratitude. Now is the time to fight. Sorry, I owe you one.
You tried your best but didn't stand a chance alone. How sad, how sad.
Aw, Rika.
Rika-chan gently patted my head for me. But there was no mindless pity in the palm of that hand. It was overflowing with a strong, dependable feeling of, leave the rest to us.
I can't wait to see what they do.
Mion can't join us due to various circumstances, so I'll temporarily be taking command. Our strategy will revolve around Shio's defense and the extermination of the enemy's combat capability.
Who's the enemy? Are there a lot of them?
From this point forward, anybody who messes with Shion shall be considered an enemy combatant. There are no rules of engagement. Compensation will be the dessert you just ate. Any questions? Everybody had already entered club mode, their eyes peering at the riffraff clambering around inside the restaurant like predators stalking their prey from the darkness. Rika-chan held up her hand. What is it, Rika-chan?
Do we have to show mercy?
Oh my god!
Of course we don't have to! We have no need to show mercy to the rabble that would dare lay a finger on Mion's little sister. Then it's okay, Keiichi?
Rika-chan was serious. She was really ready to pretty much murder someone. I'm counting on you, Rika-chan. I, Keiichi Marubara, shall assume all responsibility. Route them.
Alrighty! Rina's gonna do her best too!
Sorry. Please do.
Keiichi-san, you don't have to be so tense. Well, just wait and see. By the time you finish that parfait, we'll have finished cleaning up too. Well then, everyone. Let's give it our all. Go for it, yay! Yay!
That's the most powerful warband the world had ever known, trained by Mion, began to move. I was the oldest, the only boy, and behaved like leader, but when you consider our club activities, I was by far the most junior member. Individually, everyone besides me had terrifying combat capabilities. All of them combined their strengths to protect Shion. I couldn't even imagine. I was probably about to witness something terrible and awe-inspiring. Sanazaki-san! 5 deluxe parfaits for table 7!
Sure thing!
Shion carried the order to the tables. For Shion to carry all 5 parfaits without wobbling took so much effort that she didn't have the breathing room to pay attention to her feet.
Comrades, here she comes yet again! This time I'll have her spill everything on my pants and have her wipey-wipey right down to my underwear.
It was the same wipey-wipey scheme that had occurred just a short time earlier. This time another one of them was trying it out for himself. The very depravity of these men was itself a full-out attack. Reina, engaging. Ambush them around table 5 and 6. Reina, do you copy?
The restaurant's uniforms are so cute! How? I want to take them home.
Shion, her bottom swaying while carrying the parfaits, was being chased by an equally swaying Reina. She was supposed to be escorting Shion, but Reina was instead transfixed by the black of her uniform. From a normal person's point of view, it was probably like having a fox guard a henhouse. But when it comes to Reina, things are different. Cute mode, 120% synchronization. We've
one. When Rain is in that state, even the laws of physics don't apply. Shion's legs, unsteady and defenseless, were being targeted by those sleazebags.
No, my comrades! Heil mein Führer, Shining Lucifer of the Harumi Mecha!
Legs snaked out to trip Shion's defenseless feet. Egads, three of them at once! Fat, fat, fat!
Yeah, oof! Whoa! It happened in an instant. The three fools writhed in pain as their legs bent at unnatural angles. Arr! Wait, what is this madness?
Raina teetered into view and gave them a warning.
No! No mischief, okay? No means no! No! Raina's going to be the one to take her home!
This girl! What's with that strange technique?
The human scum clutched at their bruised ankles as they passed out.
That's our Raina-san. No matter how many times I see it, it's always frighteningly quick.
Yeah, it's an unbreakable barrier. Anyone within a 2-meter radius who attacks Shion is completely obliterated by Raina. Oh god. As Shion was making her rounds to the restaurant, there were people here and there collapsing with welts on their legs and hands.
Keichi-kun, this is Raina. There's nobody left that'll bother Shion, so I'm going to take her home now.
Raina, this is Keichi. Good work. Please continue the mission. Also, permission to take home denied. I repeat, permission to take home denied.
I'll just look.
I guess just looking is fine. That probably wouldn't prevent her from guarding Shion, so I guess it's okay. Anyway, thanks to this, I knew who had tried to mess with Shion. Yeah. That's English. Anybody who was clutching at their arm or leg while they were writhing in agony is basically branded by their bruises. Currently, we have finished identifying all enemy forces. Proceeding to the next phase. Satoko, this is Keiichi. What's your status?
This is Satoko. That's a rude way to ask.
Wow, I just went country there.
Ask. That's a rude way to ask. Keiichi-san, exactly who do you think I am?
Satoko was in the kitchen. She had spread open a sketch of the restaurant on the counter, replete with order sheets in their destinations. It was now sorting through the freshly made desserts.
Uh-oh.
Hey, what are you doing?
Now.
Sonozaki-san, it's alright just to leave it to her. More importantly, we're taking all these orders out at once, so I'm counting on you. Veteran waitress was briskly directing her juniors as the trays went out, one after another. All the desserts that had passed through Satoko's hands were delivered at once.
Oh.
I had a burp.
Lots of cute desserts are coming! Oh.
I think you'll know this, but don't touch them. At least if you still value your life.
No, but...
Certainly they were all incredibly cute-looking desserts. They were all works of art that you could enjoy before even taking your first bite. However, since Satoko had meddled with them, they were nothing more than an unpredictable danger. Blissfully ignorant of the fact that were the men that now stuffing their faces.
Oh no.
This is...
Almost right away, they realized that something was wrong. Satoko, what did you mix in there? It couldn't have been salt or Tabasco, right?
My, what are you saying, Keiichi-san? You said no mercy. I might not look like it, but when I get down to business, I like to be very thorough.
As she said that, she twirled a dubious file in her fingers before putting it away smartly into her pouch.
Rika, this is Satoko. Customers are moving,
Escort duty is all yours. Leave it to me. Come to think of it, I didn't see Rika-chan anywhere. Where could she be lurking?
Under the tables.
Clatter, clatter. Several men stood up suddenly from their seats, surveying the restaurant for something. That restless fidgeting. And that look of relief when they found the single placard hanging from the ceiling. Written on that placard was the word, restroom. They began a mad rush in that direction. It wasn't just one or two people. All the people that were branded as the enemy were standing up from their seats while clutching at their stomachs.
I think I was a little too greedy. Where's the washroom? Mewtwo!
Mewtwo.
Not a number one, but a number two.
Mewtwo.
I need to cash out now.
Where's the toilet? I found it! You're in for it now!
Felt dirty just thinking about what Sathika probably did to their desserts. Problem was how to follow this up. I was intrigued, so I followed the rush of men to the washroom. The narrow hallway connected to the restroom was crammed with about 10 men.
Wait, what is this?
As I peered over to see what was happening.
Whoa!
It seemed that the toilet was clogged and backflowing, unleashing a loud gurgling sound with a terrible stench. There was no way to use it in this state. Damn that Sathika, what a frightening display of power. And no, this wasn't Sathika's doing. It was divine punishment. Yeah, they were just unlucky. I'll just apologetically ask one of the employees here to clean it up.
I can't do my business like this. Arr! What do we have now, comrades?
It was a brilliant combination of traps, but it would be better if there was one more push to the kicker. Seeing as it was Sathika, she wouldn't have overlooked that.
Now that it's come to this, it is time for the last resort.
Oh no.
Faced with a moral dilemma, that man only had one other option. Women's restroom!
Isn't using the girls' room going to get us in trouble? I'm pretty sure there's no female customers today. Why didn't I think of that before? Women's toilets are the best!
Oh no.
What a brazen bunch they are. The men, sweat now pouring from their brows, made a mad rush to the girls' room without any hesitation.
Here's the last kicker.
Oh, it's gonna be Vika. Me? There was girl there! It was Rika-chan.
That was girl there!
The men stood there, frozen, in various complicated poses, indicating their surprise. Rika-chan also seemed dumbfounded by the sudden turn of events. But the look on her face was strangely perfect. This was all part of the plan as well. You sly dog, Rika-chan. I should never underestimate you.
This you see, mademoiselle. Me. The men's room is a bit dangerous at the moment, so we just want to borrow the toilet, right? Meow. Meow.
Is he a freaking cat? Like...
Me. But, I guess it's not right after all. Right, my comrades.
Just by having a girl stand there in the restroom, I never knew it could put up such an overwhelming barrier. There was no way anybody could be brave enough to lift Rika-chan out of the way and try to do their business. This was the most they could do after all. If it were a man in full club mode, for example, someone like me, they would plow through Rika without a second thought. Now what are you going to do, fat asses? The price for tormenting Shion still hasn't been paid.
If you're in trouble, I can help you.
That would be much appreciated!
How would you do that? You can use one of the toilets outside. I'll show you to them.
That would be perfect! Please!
At this rate, it'll end up becoming a group enema parade.
Rika-chan, with a pleasant smile on her face, guided them with a casual stride in her step. In this race against time, her slow pace was sadistic torture.
Mademoiselle, is this toilet far from here?
We'll get there soon. Obeying Rika-chan's directions, they were about to leave the restaurant.
Keichi-kun, finish it! Give him hell!
Yeah, leave it to me! I spread my arms out and blocked them as they tried to leave the restaurant.
What is the meaning of this? We're at DEFCON 1 here!
Listen up, you tubs of lard. You know what happens if you even set 1 foot outside this door, right?
What is the meaning of this preposterous statement?
Preposterous statement.
Look, it's written right here on the ticket.
Not valid for re-entries.
Not valid for re-entries, see?
You're free to use any toilet you want, but the moment you step outside that door, you can't come back.
Boom!
You remember this?
I don't want to guide anybody who says scary things like that.
Everybody panicked as Rika-chan began to turn back. They could only figuratively and literally fall in line. All the waitresses also lined up to see them off.
Thank you very much for coming.
We shall return!
Clang, clang.
The bell rang playfully as the door shut behind them.
Yeah.
How pathetic. Too easy.
We did it! Yay!
Rain and Seth go clap their hands together.
Whew. I couldn't hold a candle to those guys myself, but when we get the grip together, we sent them packing like a herd of cattle.
Herd of cattle!
With opponents this week, any of us could take them on by ourselves. Keichi-san, you need to up your game.
I was loath to admit it, but Sathiko was right.
Damn it!
One day, I'll be strong enough to be worthy to stand alongside them. But I'm really glad we were able to protect Michan's little sister. Now there's none of those bad people who are pulling pranks left.
You're blessed to have such wonderful friends, Sonazaki-san.
Veteran waitress was also smiling. After the herd was sent back and it calmed down completely inside the restaurant, she almost flustered as she glanced between us and the now empty seats.
You did that for me? I mean...
Shion's expression was somewhere between happy and guilt-ridden. Her face had turned slightly red as she ran into the kitchen.
Oh, Shi-chan is cute! We really are twins, huh?
Given Shion's personality, there's no way she'd thank us directly. We might have been a bit excessive in our means, but I'm really glad we were able to save her.
I think you already know this, but Sonizaki-san is very grateful. As a representative of the floor staff here, I also extend my gratitude.
Clap, 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 clap. The applause quickly spread throughout the entire restaurant. Not only the other waitresses, but also the customers that were genuinely there to enjoy the desserts. Everybody was lauding our efforts.
Oh, they did a good deed.
They kicked some fat asses. When you had mostly finished eating and were filling out the survey, Rika-chan made a return.
Oh, good work. Did everything go all right?
It took a while.
I'm sorry. I got lost on the way back. It was a lot of trouble.
Rika-chan likes to stray down some pretty strange roads. So she gets lost off pretty often.
How did she get lost just guiding people to a nearby toilet?
Everybody has their strengths and weaknesses. Rika has a lot of strong points that more than make up for that.
I can see that. That expression in the girl's room. You're quite the thespian.
Keiji was being horrible. He was thinking, if I were in their shoes, I'd just run her over and rush into the washroom.
What? Did what I was thinking show up on my face again?
Keiji-kun was a pervert!
No, I mean...
pervert.
He was a pervert.
I could laugh about it then, but a few days later, a newspaper headline read, 10 unidentified men were taken into custody in Hideyama. Men claimed they had traveled from Shishibone City by foot to find a toilet, but the spot they were taken into custody was XX kilometers away from Shishibone. When I read that article, I realized how terrifying Rika-chan really was. Well, thanks for treating me. I'm happy that you called me here today. Oh, are you going home already? You can stay a little longer. I was in the middle of organizing some drawers. If I leave it like that, I won't be able to put out the futon. Ah, I guess that's true. Oops, looks like I called her at a bad time.
Yeah, when Rena phoned her, she was in the middle of cleaning her room. But she still came.
Well, it was an emergency, so it couldn't be helped. Besides that, I got to eat a lot of sweets, so I'm very happy.
Thanks for today. Sorry for calling you out suddenly. Tell Shion I said bye.
I'll be taking my leave then. Reina-san, please take your time.
Yeah, I will. Later.
Rika and Satsuko, in a good mood, horsed around with each other as they left.
Aw, oh, man.
Ooh, I wish I had water! Not moving.
Okay. Back. While Rain and I were having a discussion about the dessert we just ate, Shion arrived with some coffee.
Oh. Did the two little ones leave already?
Hearing them call the little ones was so strange, I inadvertently burst out laughing. Apparently they were in the middle of cleaning, so they went home. Shion had brought enough coffee for four people.
I heard from my senior. It seems that you went through a lot of trouble for my sake.
It was no trouble at all. No one other than Shichan was in a pinch, after all.
I thought you said bitch.
Is it alright if I call you Shichan? It matches with Mi-chan, so I thought it'd be cute.
Well, whatever you want.
Shion seemed a bit hesitant when Reina started talking to her. Reina's pretty sharp about some things, so Shion was probably worried that Reina would find out she was Mion after talking like this. Shion said she'd have work soon and hurried off back to the kitchen, even buying coffee for just the two of us.
She was a bit upset with Reina. Maybe she thought I was being too friendly. Oh.
She's just embarrassed.
Still, they really do look the same. Instead of twins, it's like there's another Mi-chan.
They look the same, but the atmosphere around them, or rather their insides, are completely different. I think those types of twins are pretty interesting, though.
You think that, Keichi-kun? I think they're identical on the inside, too.
It somehow became silent. Reina was just staring at the pattern of the milkmaid on the surface of her coffee without saying a word. For somebody like me who could never stop talking, it was a rather uncomfortable moment. Reina's off-put mannerism seemed to imply I said something I shouldn't have. That unpleasantness carried on for a little while. Reina, you said it today, right? That Mion was hurting.
Did I say something like that?
Don't play dumb with me. You definitely said it, on the way home from school. Reina answered by laughing while continuing to play dumb, questioning if she said that. As thick-headed as I was, I had a faint realization. Reina wanted to say that I was the one who hurt Mion. But when?
Me?
Hypothetically, if something like that happened, it's not something I did out of malice. I continued the conversation but left out the assumption that I had hurt Mio.
Yeah, I think that's true. I don't think Keiji-kun had any bad intentions.
Reina replied, also leaving out the assumption that I had hurt Mio. But that confirmed it. I don't know how it happened, but it seemed that I had hurt Mion. And Reina was upset with me due to the fact that I hadn't realized it.
I don't want you to misunderstand. It's not like Reyna is... Oh.
I don't want you to misunderstand. It's not like Reyna is mad at you.
Seeing right through what I was thinking, Reyna said that as she smiled even more gently than usual.
It's just that... How do I say this? It's hard.
If I made a mistake, please say so clearly. I'm so thick-headed, I disgust me even myself. If there's something I should apologize for, then I want to know even a little quicker so I can make up for it.
I don't think that Keichi made a mistake. Depending on how you look at it, Mii-chan might be the one who's being unfair. Taking the stance that the girl was the one being unfair might be unfair in itself.
What Reyna said was draped in mystery. Unfortunately, I had no idea what she meant. The only thing I got out of it was that I had said or done something to inadvertently hurt Mio. I'm begging you, Reyna. Mio's one of my best friends. I don't want to leave something between us that could cause problems later on. So tell me, how did I hurt her?
I can't tell you. You need to realize something like this for yourself.
Reyna was smiling like she always did, but spoke bluntly. The fact that she had this strength of will surprised me for a moment. I'm asking you because I can't figure it out, you know? My tone unintentionally became harsh. Reyna was also surprised for a moment, but quickly returned to her flat demeanor.
Well then, I guess just a hint is fine. This is special, okay?
Sorry, please. I'll think about this seriously. Reyna looked around the restaurant, searching for Shion. Shion was working enthusiastically, but without confidence as usual.
Shi-chan, if she ties her hair up, it's impossible to tell apart from Mii-chan, right?
Yeah, that's true.
So if Mii-chan let her hair down, would she be impossible to tell apart from Shi-chan?
Probably. But what does that have to do with anything?
What if that her being the young twin was a lie? That she was just Mii-chan, pretending to be her sister? What would you think?
Reyna was sharper than her daily behavior lied. I was hesitant in verbally affirming that, but it was the right answer. It might be unfair to answer a question with another question, but if, like you say, Mion is just pretending to be Shion, what purpose would that serve? After maintaining the silence for a while, Reyna glanced at the clock.
That's what I want you to think about. That was maybe too much of a hint.
After thanking me for the dessert, Reyna stood up from her seat.
Sorry, I was asked to buy a few things, so it's about time I left. Is it okay with you if you tell Shion I'm sorry I didn't say goodbye?
Yeah, I'll tell her.
Sorry.
Huh?
Irina is so short-tempered. Sorry for getting angry. Keichi-kun isn't the only one at fault here.
Reyna was harsh in her apology, but I was the one who really should have apologized.
Think to Mii-chan, it's something that doesn't bother her much anymore. So if you want to forget the whole thing happened, that's fine too. But you see, as a girl, I'd hope that Keichi-kun realizes it by himself and comes to apologize of his own volition.
Switching to cute mode only at the end, she disappeared in the direction of the register. Just getting sore. Raspy. While I was staring into space, somebody suddenly tapped me on the shoulder.
Sorry to keep you waiting. I'm finally done.
It was Shion who had changed into her street clothes. She flashed a smile while greeting me. Thank you so much for today. Everything was delicious. We were all happy with it.
Oh no, don't mention it. But I'm glad everybody had fun.
Huh?
That girl that was just here left as well?
She had some shopping to do. She said she was sorry for leaving without saying anything.
I see.
Well then, should we leave as well? Even though I'm off duty, I'm still nervous around the workplace. We ended up strolling around without any destination in particular.
I'd been sitting the entire time, so I was in need of a breath of fresh air. When we left, the sky had already become draped in a veil of darkness.
Ah, it's gotten dark already. Even though I promised I'd be finished early.
She didn't seem upset that there wasn't much time left.
Oh well, at least we've got a little time to chat like this.
Saying that, Shion set out for the tree-lined boulevard behind the station. The front of the station was slowly becoming crowded with businessmen heading home.
Well then, I guess just to start with an introduction. I was mistaken for my sister when we first met, so we never got to properly introduce ourselves.
I could only smile and laugh wryly.
My name is Shion Sonozaki. I'm only similar to my older sister in appearance. My sister is rough around the edges and hot-headed, but I'm a composed and methodical person. I remember what Reina and I had been talking about earlier. I said that they looked the same but their personalities were different, while Reina said they were both the same. I don't know what tipped her off, but Reina figured out that Shion was Mio. Also related to that, she said that I had hurt Mio. Reina had only given one hint. That was, why is Mion pretending to be Shion? Shion, what did you hear about me from Mion?
My sister seems to have taken a liking to you. She talks about you quite a bit. Like about club activities, about getting pranked and pranking you back. Boyish kinds of stories. Really do get along.
Boyish kinds of stories, huh? Come to think of it, I think there was something Shion told me before.
Keichi-chan, you don't think of my sister as a girl, do you?
Was that what happened that hurt Mio? Mio herself had said she wished she had been born a boy and that being a girl didn't suit her. She said a lot of things to that effect, didn't she?
Keichi-chan, you look like you're having fun.
No, that's not true.
Even though you're bad at hiding things, you sure do. You sure like the lie, don't you? Still, I don't hate you for it.
Saying that, she lightly chopped my forehead. Even though Shion was enjoying herself, I was still trying to figure out how I had hurt Mio. I was having a hard time figuring out that riddle that Reina had left me with. Hey, see that? Don't you think it's pretty? Think even a guy would find it pretty? Yeah, it is pretty. She was having fun window shopping, dragging me by all sorts of stores I would normally never enter. It wasn't like she was begging me to buy her anything, and I wasn't getting bored either. It was just something to talk about as we walked around. In an easygoing way, we browsed through numerous stores. We discussed all sorts of topics I knew nothing about, but I didn't lose interest. I had the feeling she was good at conversation.
Keichi-chan, is this your first time doing this kind of thing?
Yeah, it is. If somebody didn't bring me into these accessory shops, I don't think I'd set foot in one my entire life.
Not that. I meant more like this.
What? I leapt back when Shion suddenly linked her arm with mine.
Hey, you don't have to act so surprised. It's not so embarrassing to link arms with a girl, is it?
Shion's expression was a little bit miffed, but suggestive at the same time.
I'm not that embarrassed.
You want some arms? I can spare one or two. Here.
Keichi-chan, you really know how to entertain someone. I see why my sister took a liking to you.
If you don't want my arm, I'm taking it back.
Aw, come on. I'm happy to have it.
Laughing in good spirits, Shio unlocked her arm with mine. My heart skipped a beat.
This question might be a bit mean, but I want to enjoy seeing your reaction. Keichi-chan, have you ever been arm-in-arm with a girl before? Around a bonfire at a field trip doesn't count, by the way.
That little devil. She was asking that question know full well what the answer would be. Well, if field trips are out, this is rough.
I thought as much.
The impish laugh. It really looks the same as Mion's. You really are Shion, right? Not just Mion saying that you're Shion, are you?
Are you thinking that my sister might pretend to be me?
I thought you were twins until just now, by the way.
by that way you mess around is just like Mion. You're just saying that. You can tell us apart easily. What do you mean by that? If my sister was holding her arm like this, would you get nervous?
I would.
I'd be completely on edge worrying that she might... that she would go for an arm lock. She even laughed so hard that she had to hold on to her sides. Hey, hey! Is it really that funny? You're tearing up! No, no. It's just... I was just thinking how hopeless my sister is. She isn't even able to get a young man hot and bother while she's arm-in-arm with him. She really is a failure as a woman. I remember once again that I heard someone say that before. Sometimes, I think that my sister would have been better off if she had been born a boy. She did. I might have fallen for her. Just kidding. Mion did say something about wanting to be born a boy. My sister is on the fence as to whether she wants to be a boy or a girl. Well, it's the price she pays for living an awkward lifestyle. Just leave her be. You've been saying some pretty harsh things about your sister right now. Mion has some soft spots to her that I don't like. The way that Shion talks somehow sounded cold. Shion, do you not get along with Mion? Well, we get along well enough. Still, there's a few things for which I can't forgive her as her sister. Hey, look at that! Don't you think it's cute? I turned around to look at where Shion was pointing. What was there was the familiar display window of a toy shop. The same shop that was the stage for the incident that occurred during last Sunday's club activities. What Shion was pointing at was a display with a plethora of adorable dolls that looked like the sort girls would like. I wonder why girls like these kinds of things.
It's because they're cute. Don't you think they're cute, Kei-chan?
I'm a man, so I don't really get that vibe.
Now. Which one do you think is the cutest out of all these, Kei-chan?
Shion, pulling on my arm, motioned to the row of dolls. They were lined up like they were close sisters taking a commemorative photo. A few of them seemed strangely familiar. I've seen those four over there somewhere.
Oh, I guess they really are famous.
I cannot talk. I'm losing it.
Don't lose it.
Even if you know about them.
Shion sounded impressed. These are new dolls that were just brought in from England. They still have some available here, but around the cities they have trouble keeping them on the shelves. Even though they're supposed to be inexpensive, it seems that they're starting to come at a premium. I guess girls still like these kinds of things even as they grow up.
It depends on the person. But I think that girls who don't like dolls and stuffed animals are pretty few and far between. Even my tomboy of a sister said these were adorable.
Oh? Even Mion said they were adorable? That is pretty amazing.
That's right. I just remembered. The Storner gave this one to us after Sunday's event.
Except for Mion, who was a relative, everybody had gotten something.
I really do think that one's the best. That frilly dress really gives it something.
That's it. That's the one the shop owner gave to me.
So it seems.
Shion replied softly, but clearly. Uncle Yoshiro gave those out as thanks for helping liven things up at Sunday's event.
It seems he gave them to the four friends my sister brought along. So you got the doll with the dress then. What did you think? It was really cute, right?
As a man, there's no way I'd think it was cute.
So what did you do with the doll?
I wasn't really going to do anything with it, so I gave it to someone.
To who?
As Shion laughed, I could hear an audible click run through my head, like the piece of a jigsaw puzzle snapping into place.
He gave it to Reina.
Thank you very much for today, everyone. You made the event turn out great. It's not much, but here's something extra for today.
Uncle Yoshido, isn't there a little something for me, too? My. Quite an adorable one, is it not?
When Satoko and Riku-chan opened up the bag, there were cute little stuffed animals inside.
Wow! They're so cute! Can I take them home? I really can?
Which means there was something for me, too. Whoa! I got a pretty adorable one. It was a stuffed toy wearing a beautiful dress, one you'd use to play house. Reina's eyes were glued to my stuffed doll. Satoko was the same, and Riku-chan too? I see. It wasn't just Reina, Satoko, and Riku-chan. There was one other person who seemed jealous. Keichi-chan got the one that fits him the least. Not wanting her for her expression to give it away, she had said that to hide her embarrassment. While I guess it's cute and pretty, I can admit it's adorable, but a doll with changeable clothes is, eh. If you walked around with it, then you'd be treated like a weirdo starting tomorrow, definitely. Mion's usual teasing way of talking. I looked around to see who I should give the doll to. Mion was right in front of me. Mion was the only one who hadn't received a present, so I thought about giving it to her. But I didn't.
Huh? You're giving it to me? To Reina? Thank you!
Turning away from Mion's covetous gaze, I gave the doll to Reina. Mion's smile bore into my back. There was no way that I couldn't have noticed. Why did I not give it to Mio? Since Mio was the only one who didn't get anything, wouldn't it have just been a standard practice to give it to her? That time, I had noticed that something was wrong. That's why I said it. Just protecting myself. If I didn't give it to Reina, then walking to the streets at night would be scary.
No doubt.
I thought about giving it to Mion, but it just didn't feel right. Something dark flickered briefly in Mion's eyes, but at the time I didn't notice. I thought to give it to Mion, why didn't I?
You know it. I sometimes wonder why I wasn't born a boy.
Mion herself had said that with a laugh, so I didn't realize that I had hurt her. This is a definitely more personal story than Chapter 1.
Yeah.
That's right. Mion is more suited for cool things. So I think having you help out here was the right choice.
Huh?
Shion asked, probably thinking she had misheard me.
That uniform, it would never suit somebody like Mion. But if it's Shion, I think it works.
Huh? You mean that,
Shion, like Reina often does, spaced out and turned bright red. Mion seemed really happy. She seemed happy that I complimented Shion. Saying that it didn't suit Mion, but that it suited Shion. Saying that it suited her seemed to make her happy.
Mion's younger twin sister.
She's got a different personality, but she's a dead ringer for Mion.
That's right. We look similar, but our personalities are completely different. I'm very kind and thoughtful, but Shion has a cold and scary personality.
I think that when you guys were born, Shion got all the feminine aspects. Like Mion, she's a cute, cheerful girl. Mion made a strange face that was both angry and happy at the same time. Seems she was happy that I said Shion was cute. Sneaking a look inside the box to say that she just put some of the leftovers inside would have been a lie. There was an elegant meal stuffed inside. Is it really okay? There's not like a ton of hot sauce mixed in or anything, right?
Jeez, I'm not my sister. I wouldn't do that kind of thing.
If you don't like it, you don't have to force yourself. I'll just go home and eat it myself. I'm not my sister. That was how she said it. Shion was insistent that she wasn't Mion. She was saying that she was Shion and that I shouldn't think of her as Mion. When Mion was Shion, it carried a special meaning.
Mion is mysterious, right? She's a girl, but she's like a guy.
but it's like she's a guy.
That's what Reina said.
But you see, even the Mii-chan is actually really feminine.
Reina, how much did Mion pay you exactly?
That's not true! Jeez, I'm trying to have a serious conversation, you know?
Reina began to pout. Now probably wasn't the right time to joke around.
Mii-chan is club president, so she's trying hard to leave her, hate everybody. But she's really a very cute girl. I really don't want you to forget that, Keichi-kun.
There was never a riddle to begin with. Reina was saying the answer right from the beginning. So then I don't know what's going on anymore. Yeah, I know Keichi-chan didn't mean anything wrong. At least he didn't intend to.
Yeah, Keichi-kun isn't the type of person to hurt others, so there's no reason for you to feel hurt by this, Mii-chan.
Then what was it? Frustration? Sadness? I don't know at all.
Did you want it? At all, I mean. Even if you gave it to me, Reina,
that wouldn't solve anything. You're right.
How about this, Mii-chan? Try asking Keichi-kun. You might be able to solve the problem if you tackle it head-on.
There's no way I could do that. Is it too embarrassing to do that now? I'm gonna try again, as somebody other than Mio. This time, I can be more honest with myself. Don't get me wrong, I'm pretty fond of the relationship I have with Keichi-chan. This might be selfish, but one more time.
Keichi-kun will definitely notice!
I wonder if that's true.
Reina will cheer you on too! Let's find a way for you to ease your sadness! Believe me, I won't let anything happen that'll make you cry, Mii-chan!
I'll believe.
Keichi-kun will definitely come to understand. He'll say he's sorry for saying something so callous that'll bring you to that store and buy that doll for you as a present.
Yeah.
And then Mii-chan, you'll say, thank you. You can't fool around. Say it honestly.
Yeah. I said I wanted it, Keichi-chan. Would you buy it for me? Mion said it quietly, doing her best to quell her embarrassment. I would have reflexively begun to lightly tease her to hide my embarrassment. Like Mion, I quelled that impulse. Okay, Mion. As thanks for everything until today, I'll buy you whichever one you want. My voice cracked with the unfamiliar words. In order to not lose to Mion's trying her best, I tried my best as well. But I'm not Mion, I'm Shion. Shion, then. I'll buy it for you, Shion. Shion looked down, red-faced. She pointed at the doll and addressed the store window. Is it really okay? The one in the dress is a little expensive, isn't it? This isn't a matter of price. This is a matter of feelings. When I was saved by Keichi-chan from those unsavory customers today, I was really happy. Even though my coworkers didn't save me, Keichi-chan did. You grabbed me by the shoulder really firmly, right? Right then, you were really cool. Even then, I was so embarrassed I couldn't properly express my gratitude. I clamped my hand down on Shion's head and held their hair roughly, like I would do to Reina and the others. And did that, Shion, like Reina, would have spaced out and blushed slightly. You don't have to think too hard about it. I should have just given it to you back then. If I did that, then everybody would have had a good laugh. Shion didn't respond. She turned bright light red like she was trying to hold back laughter and tears. I'll go buy it for you right now. Right there. I'll go with you. Saying that, she grabbed onto my arm once again. She wasn't trying to be stoic anymore. I think I know why my sister likes you. Hey, is it alright if I start to like you a bit too, Keichi-chan? The
familiar situation made my head start to spin. Whoa,
what am I doing?
I had reached my limit. Smiling wryly to hide my embarrassment, I dragged Shion into the store with me.
Excuse me. I want to buy that doll and the dress that's in the window.
After a moment, I heard a voice of acknowledgement and an apron-clad employee soon appeared.
Uh-oh.
That's not good.
Uh-oh. Oh, shit!
Shit's about to get real.
Oh, no. No.
Keichi-chan? And why are you here? This has nothing to do with you. I'm on a date with Keichi-chan right now.
Huh? What? What?
Why is Keichi-chan?
Even if you ask why, I'd like to know the answer myself! Mia looked at me with an expression of confusion and surprise.
Oh no.
That was the same with me! She was there. Mia was next to me.
I said it right at the beginning. I'm Shion Sonozaki, my sister's younger twin. Keichi-chan, you even called me Shion, didn't you?
Shion, saying that, pouted cutely.
What is going on? Tell me, Shion. Not much. I was wondering what kind of person this Keichi-chan you were so infatuated with was. So I happened to give him a ticket to the dessert festa. There, when I was being bothered by all sorts of troublesome customers, Keichi-chan gallantly appeared and saved me by kicking him all to the curb, or something like that.
Both Mion and I raised our voices pathetically, expressing our confusion to the utmost. Mion, you phoned me. Yesterday, right?
I didn't! I have no idea what you're talking about! I delivered that bento for you, didn't I, Keichi-chan? That was me, right?
Oh,
or
no.
Was it my sister?
Oh no!
The person known as Mion Sonozaki put together a bento and bravely went to a boy's home to deliver it, maybe? Oh, you're a lot bolder than you look, sis!
With a loud pop, a trail of smoke began to rise from Mion's head.
No, I don't know.
See, Keichi-chan, my sister says she doesn't know. So everything up until yesterday was me, Shion Sonozaki. You might have thought it was my sister pretending to be me, but with this, there's no doubt, right?
I couldn't tell up from down at that moment. If there was a mirror around, I could have seen my eyes go wide from the shock.
Now, little Miss Shopkeeper, could you wrap up that doll in the window? It's the first present from the person I've come to love, so make sure you tip it up tie it up nicely with a ribbon.
Mion, completely flustered, was being cornered by a sly-faced Shion. My brain had stopped working.
Wait.
What? Huh?
What is going on?
Well, let's go. Keichi-chan, it's already dark out, so I'll see you home. Sorry, but could you phone the house in Okinomiya and have them send out a car? Maybe a van that we can fit a bike into, please.
In contrast to Shion, who had glee written all over her face, Mion was an empty shell that looked like she could burst into tears at any moment.
Keichi-chan.
After that moment, Mion's grumblings were unrelenting.
He's gonna stop it right here. Come on, Keichi-chan! Come on! No! No!
Fucking love triangle!
I knew it was gonna happen! I knew it was gonna be a love triangle!
Why does it have to end like that?
Been a while.
Sorry, John.
Not easy being green.
Oh no. Poor Keichi-chan. New tips.
Poor Keichi-chan and poor Mion.
Shion is a little devil.
Yeah.
She's like, oh, I'm gonna bring you to the toy store where Mion is and show you off.
Stop saying it's been a while. We've seen each other every day up until yesterday, haven't we?
Whatever.
If you say so, we'll go with that. Someone from Shion's house came to get me in a station wagon. I'd initially refused, but Shion insisted, so both my bicycle and I ended up stuffing the car. Said car was currently driving across the single bumpy road leading to Namizawa. Goodness sake, Shion was at Mio's level at least, or maybe even better actor either way. No matter what questions I pressed her with, she'd slip out of them like an eel. Still, you two look so alike. If you tied your hair back like Mion does, would you look exactly like her? Who knows? That's probably what would happen. We're identical twins through and through. In the past, we could just change our clothes and no one would be the wiser. I remember we'd swap places at every opportunity and fooled a whole lot of people. The middle-aged driver wearing a black suit heaved a heavy sigh, like he were a butler. What's wrong, Kasai? That was a pretty deep sigh.
Excuse me. I was just thinking that you haven't changed.
You can see many years of hardship on the man's face through a rearview mirror.
Anyway, Keichi, your house was around here, right?
Kasai doesn't know much about Hanamizawa aside from the road that goes to Sonazaki main house. If you leave it to him, he'll take you all the way to Yagouchi.
I don't want that!
Excuse me, could you stop at the narrow road on the next right?
I'll walk from there.
He stopped the car at the desired place. The driver, Kasai-san, got my bike out of the trunk for me. Sorry about that. Thank you very much for showing me home today.
Whoa. Was it Kasai-san?
Your name, that is. Yes.
You must be having various difficulties, but I believe she will grow tired soon. So please endure things until then.
Gave me a deep, deep look of sympathy. This guy's definitely been dealing with the Sonazaki sisters ever since they were little kids.
So that means she'll be as much of a bother as Mion, right?
The man's face froze in a smile. His reply lost.
Hey, pack me up here.
Bye, Kei-chan. We'll see each other again soon. Say hi to my sister for me, too. Maybe I'll start going to Hinamizawa tomorrow.
Oh, no.
Don't you dare. If you transfer in, I'll transfer out to a school in Okinomiya.
Wow, that was really mean, Kei-chan.
Man.
A short beep of the horn. The man gave a little wave to me from the driver's seat. Then the car withdrew into the dark night roads, leaving dust in its wake. Man, this entire day made no sense. I ran into Mion while I was with Shion. The former's expression, like a pigeon shot with a pelican, had finally begun to make a strong impression on me.
Why? Why is he so unlucky?
It's just Cage. It's just a man born with no luck.
Holy crap. I'm sorry, Blake.
Hour and a half. That's looking about right.
Well then, we hope you enjoyed that
episode of, oh my god, what the fuck just happened? Anyway.
Love triangle confirmed. Or is it just the romance between Keichi and Mion? And Shion is just
hot fire, spitting hot fire.
Yeah, I think Shion's
like Roy Mustang. Just
okay. I bet you Mion admitted her feelings to Shion, and Shion was like, "I'm gonna fuck this up."
I don't think she admitted it. I think it was just inferred. She gathered enough clues from Mion. She's like, "We'll pay this Keichi a visit."
Or she had. No, well, that meeting was an accident.
Yeah, that meeting was an accident. So, but she finally put the face to the name, and she took advantage of that. Maybe not initially. Maybe she does have a liking for him. We don't know yet. All we know is that, unlike the first chapter, or unlike the first episode, where kind of Reina was the main love interest until that got just crazy.
Maybe Shion's gonna be. Ooh.
who's gonna be the next psychopath.
I'm calling Shio.
I'm thinking Shio.
Shio or Mio? Especially when she was like, maybe I'll turn into Namizawa. And it's like,
it's gonna be one of the two. One of the two is gonna snap. We'll see after the Watanagashi festival. Alright, which will hopefully be in the next episode. Okay, we'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!